Well, I hope I have your attention. Is that a word? First of all, I just want to say before I comment on my remarks is God has an amazing way of divine intervention. And about mid-April, when the doctor sent Ellie home to die, I started to do a lot of research on the internet. And I found a site that was for Charlotte Metro Hyperbaric Chamber. And I sent an email. That email should have been directly to the office, but instead it found its way to Bob Sands in San Diego. And that is how Bob and I became friends, and he stood by my side in developing a treatment for Ellie. And I believe that he gave our family about 3 more months. Thank you. And snuggling in that chamber with Ellie for a 90-minute movie, 5 days every week, the greatest blessing. She never let me touch her during her time at chemo in the hospital. It's a beautiful therapy. And oxygen is a gift from God. Ellie and Grace were born on October 31st, Halloween babies. The miracle of twins is beyond words. What a blessing to have little girls born with bright blue eyes and blonde hair. Ellie was our pink little princess, always wearing a happy little smile. She loved life, she loved snuggling, and her ability to show love was amazing. I was told throughout my days, Mommy, Mommy, what do you want, Ellie? Mommy, I love you. She just melted your heart. I remember at the age of 4, Ellie came tugging at my skirt, and I looked down and I said, what do you want, honey? And she said, Mommy, do you know that I specialize in kindness? Only a child of God would say those words. And soon we would learn that indeed our Ellie was an angel sent from the heavens to fulfill her purpose in only 8 years of life. On July 2nd, 2008, we were preparing for our July 4th celebration, and it was beyond my wildest comprehension that cancer would soon crash through our home without warning. Cancer would come in such a hellish fury, I had no warning of how to protect my daughter, Ellie. Cancer is a family disease. It can tear a family apart. It can shatter hearts. But it also stole my child's innocence. It introduced her all too early of the world of suffering. On July 4th, the first day of her chemotherapy treatment in July of 2008, I went up to her and I said, Ellie, I said, sweetie, we found a name for your boo-boo, and it's called cancer. And she looked at me and she said, Mommy, am I going to die? And I paused and I looked at her and I said, honey, I said, only God knows when we're going to die, but we have a motto, and that motto is, we're in it to win it. Ellie took those words to heart, and her inspirational fight became known around the world. She taught millions the true meaning of courage, hope, faith, and love. Her CaringBridge site had over 2 million hits and over 12,000 followers on Twitter. In fact, many celebrities, including Lance Armstrong and Miley Cyrus, twittered about Ellie's heroic fight. It is indescribable to me to even attempt to paint the picture of pediatric cancer. The journey will bring a mother to her knees as the pain and agony to watch your daughter fade away as you willingly sign the hospital paperwork to poison and burn your little daughter. During those times, my strength came from prayers and my never-ending hope that cancer could be destroyed. Our Ellie was a fighter, and up until her last breath, she looked at me, tears were flowing down my face. I could not believe that this bright, valiant little warrior were just steps away from earning her wings. I will never forget, in the midst of our own pain, she struggled to breathe, but she slowly raised each of her arms, kissing slowly each one of her biceps. And she said, "Mommy, I'm a fighter, I'm strong, I'm not gonna die." Ellie never gave up hope in her belief that she would kick cancer's butt. And today I'm here to tell you, with firm belief, that Ellie would be still playing at the beach today if I had been educated in 2008 on the alternative therapies for cancer. But I didn't know. This is what I heard on July 2nd of 2008. Our oncologist brought us into a small room, and he stated very matter-of-factly, "I'm sorry, but your daughter has a rare pediatric cancer, stage 4 rhabdomyosarcoma. And unfortunately, we have very little research on this cancer. There's only about 350 kids who get this type of cancer per year in the United States, and only 10% get stage 4. The main tumor in her pelvic area is about the size of an orange, and it's metastasized to her lungs, and there's about 30 tumors the size of walnut. But the good news is we have an advisory board of rhabdo specialists around the United States. They're from St. Jude, Sloan Kettering, MD Anderson, and you're going to start our gold standard protocol. And with that being said, she'll have a 40% chance of survival over 4 or 5 years. To my horror, I learned that Ellie's chemo protocol was over 30 years old. The best treatment was a cocktail of poisons that would break down her immune system and destroy her body over the next 10 months. Additionally, Ellie would have 30 days straight of radiation that would burn her lungs and her pelvic region inside and out, and I would have to use burn cream on her skin to help heal her wounds. After living in the hospital on and off for 10 months, Ellie achieved remission after 42 rounds of chemotherapy in May of 2009. Sadly, less than 3 months later, Ellie relapsed, and her fight was far from over. The statistical survival of Ellie was now at 10%. We had tried the big guns, the gold standard, the 30-year-old treatment therapy, and it had failed, as was suspected. In considering Ellie's quality of life, we started her on a second outpatient chemo regime in October of 2009. It failed to work. Then we tried a third outpatient chemo treatment. Once again, it failed to work. On December 28th, 2009, behind closed doors, my husband and I were told that Ellie had 4 weeks to live. The tumors in her lungs were growing aggressively, and she would die through suffocation. What do you do when your child wants to fight? Ellie wanted to live. With great heaviness, we didn't know what else to do. So we did the fourth last inpatient chemotherapy treatment. It was a combination of about 8 chemotherapy poisons. It was in hopes to cure our daughter. Every third week, Ellie would go into that hospital for 6 days in a row to be admitted for chemotherapy. My days and nights would consist of bedpans and puke buckets, watching the little girl I love more than my life be poisoned and made very sick. To watch the first drop of poison infused in your child is nauseating, horrifying, and surreal. How could our top specialist in cancer believe that by destroying our immune system we could cure cancer? For Ellie and the majority of children, it does not. Ellie's last chemo protocol failed after 3 months, and in mid-April, Ellie was sent home to die. According to our oncologist, nothing in the world could save our daughter's life. The cancer had won. As her mother, that was not good enough. We took Ellie home to live. Ellie celebrated the idea of never going back to the hospital. In fact, her new name for all of the staff members were idiots. Yeah. It became the mindset that Ellie would finally be healed through God. And as I educated myself late into the night, I became immersed in this fascinating world of alternative cancer treatment. Brilliant! There was an actual logic behind the therapy, building up the immune system to allow our own bodies to attack the cancer. Understanding the odds we faced, Ellie and I joined together to begin our quest of total healing in mind, body, and spirit. The whole family joined together to participate in the cancer healing diet. Vitamins, supplements, oxygen therapy, chiropractic care, cranial and sacral treatments. We could participate. With chemotherapy, we couldn't. Why would we poison ourselves? But we would poison our own daughter. How messed up is that? Together now, we were in it to win it. You know what, and this was the only time in those 2 years of our battle against cancer that I actually felt like a good mom and that I was taking good care of my daughter. I know today in my heart that our Ellie lived more days on earth with less pain because of our efforts to rebuild her immune system. The great tragedy is simply it was too late. After over 60 chemotherapy treatments using over 50 agents of poison, as well as 30 days of radiation, Ellie's body was shutting down. The treatments had created super cancer cells through the mutation that happened through the chemo resistance. Ellie died 4 weeks ago on one day in our home, with family and friends gathered by her side in vigil for over 48 hours. When Ellie finally reached up and took her last breath, I cried to her, I said, "Fly, baby, fly, go with your angels." And a strange peace came over me. Ellie was finally healed of all cancer in heaven. Her cycle of life was complete. Through tragedy, purpose was to be born. I know Ellie's bright spirit is in this room with us today, right now. In fact, I feel her by my side. I know Ellie is cheering on in my efforts to build the Lift Up Foundation. Let no more children suffer and die of pediatric cancer. Find another way. Burning, poisoning, cutting are not cures. It's barbaric, and it must not continue. When Ellie was diagnosed in July 2008, 2 months later, my husband and I created the Lift Up Foundation, which is a 501c nonprofit. And we promised each other the day that Ellie was healed that we would begin our new journey. And Ellie is healed. And that is why I'm here today in California when I should be in fetal position back in Charlotte, North Carolina, because I'm here to continue on with Ellie's fight. We are going to support other families to give access to the best conventional as well as alternative treatment around the world for cancer. We are not only going to raise awareness of pediatric cancer, but educate the public on the alternative treatment options, as well as fostering exchange and growth in the academic community. We need to understand how cancer cells are formed. Can we stop the cells from replication? What does the cancer feed on? How can simple immune-boosting strategies break the cancer cycle. I believe if Ellie had oxygen therapy, as Bob Sand says, God's gunpowder, for the first day of her chemotherapy back in July 2008, she'd be home right now with her twin sister. The natural organic treatment, the gift from God. Oxygen helps create new stem cells, boost the immune system to fight off the cancer. Could oxygen therapy be the difference between life and death for thousands of children fighting pediatric cancer? I believe it is. And America needs to put some money behind the research. And the Lift Up Foundation is willing to be the voice for change and do what it can financially. I ask you today, for anyone who's interested in being involved in our organization and using your skills, talents, education, connection, or resources, I would be honored to have you join us. Change begins with one person who has a vision that is backed up by passion and dedication. But it will take many hands to lift up pediatric cancer to create the change. But I have no doubt that together we can continue to fight Ellie's cancer battle with her leading the way from above. And I'm proud to say we are still in it to win it.